Hi, everyone. In this video, we are going to take a look at what are called binary arithmetic operators. In this context, we are using the word binary to refer to operations that involve two operands or values. For example, 10 plus 5 is a binary operation because it involves two values, 10 and 5. Here are Python's binary arithmetic operators. We have the addition operator, which uses the plus sign. We have the subtraction operator, which uses the minus sign. We have the multiplication operator, which uses the asterisk. We have the division operator, which uses the forward slash. There's also the floor division operator, which uses two forward slashes. And then finally, we have the modulo operator, which uses the percent sign. So now let's go ahead and take a look at some examples. I encourage you to type the code as you follow along and to write your own examples in order to test your understanding. Don't hesitate to pause or rewind the video if you need a bit more time to review, but on the other hand, you can also speed up the video if you find the pace to be a bit slow. Okay, so first, let's take a look at some addition operations. And let me just highlight a few points. When adding values that involve negation, such as in the second example, the negation happens first before the values are added. And this is true for all the other arithmetic operations that we will discuss in this video. So in this case, 7 is negated first before 2 is added, resulting in a value of negative 5. The result will change if we put 7 plus 2 in parentheses. This will instead perform the addition first and then negate the result. So this one will instead output negative 9. Another thing that I'd like to highlight is that if both operands are floats, or even if one of them is an integer but the other is a float, then the result will be a float as well. As a general rule, when you mix integers and floats in arithmetic operations, the result will be in the float data type. So let's go ahead and run this to verify the results. And here we see the expected output. For those of you writing your own examples, I suggest that you also create ones that make use of variables so that you can practice how to work with them as well. Next, we've got some subtraction operations here. So let's go ahead and run this. And here we see the expected output as well. And then here we've got some multiplication operations. They use the asterisk symbol as the operator. Let's go ahead and run this as well to verify the results. And here they are. And here we have some division operations. Division operations use a forward slash. Now for this one, take note that in division operations, even if both numbers are integers, the result will always be in the form of a float. For example, 7 divided by 2 gives us 3.5. And even 6 divided by 2 will result in a float. This will give us 3.0 instead of just 3. So let's go ahead and run this. And here we see the expected output as well. And here we have some floor division examples. If you just use one forward slash, then Python performs a true division. But if you use two forward slashes, then that would lead to floor division instead. In a floor division operation, the quotient is rounded down to the nearest integer. So if you do a floor division of negative 7 divided by 2, then instead of getting negative 3.5, it gets rounded down to the nearest integer, which is negative 4. Now take note that in floor division, as opposed to true division, if both operands are integers, then the result will also be an integer. So let's go ahead and run this. And here we see the expected output as well. And then finally, we have the modulo operator. A modulo operation returns the remainder of a division operation. For example, 7 modulo 2 gives us 1. Why do we get 1? Because 7 divided by 2 results in 3 remainder 1. So instead of returning the quotient, a modulo operation will return just the remainder, which in this example is 1. So let's go ahead and run this. And here we see the expected output as well. Now let's go ahead and take a look at a slightly more complex example. Here we see that we can combine multiple operations in one larger expression. We have 15 plus 6 times 3 raised to the power of 2 divided by 18 minus 4. To evaluate this expression, we follow what's called the order of precedence of the operators. This will determine the sequence in which the operations are performed. It's not always from left to right. Among these arithmetic operators, the exponentiation operation has the highest precedence, followed by multiplication and division, and then followed by addition and subtraction. So to evaluate this properly, we start by computing for 3 raised to the power of 2, which gives us 9. Now we move on to multiplication and division. These two have the same level of precedence, so in that case, we just go from left to right. So we do the multiplication operation first, 6 times 9, which gives us 54. And then we do the division operation, 54 divided by 18, which gives us 3.0. And then we do the addition and subtraction. These two also have the same level of precedence, so we go from left to right as well. We add 15 plus 3.0, which gives us 18.0. And finally, we do 18.0 minus 4, which gives us a final result of 14.0. We can change the order in which the operations are evaluated by using parentheses. Say we put 15 plus 6 in parentheses and 18 minus 4 in parentheses as well. Parenthesized expressions have the highest precedence among all the operations in this example. So we will evaluate those first. 15 plus 6 gives us 21, and 18 minus 4 gives us 14. And then we do the exponentiation. 3 raised to the power of 2 gives us 9. And then we do the multiplication. 21 times 9 gives us 189. And then finally, we do 189 divided by 14. So the final result for this one is 13.5. Here is a table that shows the order of precedence from highest to lowest. Parenthesized expressions have the highest precedence, followed by exponentiation, followed by negation, followed by multiplication, division, floor division, and modulo. These four operations have the same level of precedence, so whenever we encounter them together, we just go from left to right. And then finally, addition and subtraction have the lowest precedence in this set. And similarly, the order of successive addition and subtraction operations is resolved by going from left to right. Okay, so now let's go ahead and look at some more examples and see if we can figure them out. What is the result of 5.0 plus 2? The answer to this is 7.0. Remember that performing an arithmetic operation on an integer and a float will result in a float. Next, what is the result of 10 divided by 5? And the answer to this is 2.0. Remember that with true division using integers, the result will be a float. And finally, what is the result of this expression? 22 plus 12 times 8, and then floor division by, in parentheses, 5 minus 2. You can pause the video while you figure out the answer. So the answer to this one is 54. We do 5 minus 2 first, because of the parentheses, so this gives us 3. And then we do 12 times 8, which gives us 96. And then we do a floor division of 96 divided by 3, giving us 32. And then we add that to 22 for a final result of 54. Okay, so now let's go ahead and take a look at one last example. Here, we have a variable x, which is equal to 5. And then we print x plus 3, so this gives us 8. However, if we print x after that, then it will still output 5, because the value assigned to x was never changed. When we print x plus 3 here, we are just printing the resulting value of this expression. But nowhere in this statement do we say that the value of x should be updated with the result. So the value of x doesn't change at this point. But in this next line here, we see x is equal to x plus 4. So what does this mean? This is an assignment statement. We have x here on the left side of the equal sign, and then on the right-hand side, we have x plus 4. So this assignment statement is trying to assign the result of x plus 4 to the same variable x. But there is no need to worry, this will not confuse Python. With assignment statements, the right-hand side will be evaluated first. So we just ignore the x on the left for the time being, and we do x plus 4 first. At this point in time, the value of x is still 5. So x plus 4 gives us 9. And then, after it's been evaluated, that value now gets assigned to x. So by the end of this assignment statement, the value of x will now be 9. And that is what this final print statement will output. So let's run this. And here we see the expected values. And that concludes this lesson on binary arithmetic operators.